beautiful decorations, for the carnival, I guess. Hello, I'm Sylvie LaRue.
I'm so glad that you are here. Welcome to the humble abode of the Cultural Society.
No, enough, Darek.
I'm wondering where my lecture is going to take place.
Right next to us, in the meeting hall. Androni, as we call it. In the past, the donations were collected there. Now it's the place of lectures and concerts.
It's going to be a pleasure to meet my readers in such interesting surroundings.
That's true. The hall has its unique atmosphere. I'd like you to take note of the recess to the right.
Oh, what's so special about it?
There's a marble tablet with a nonsensical Latin inscription. A supposedly profound meaning is hidden in those randomly arranged letters.
A tourist attraction.
Correct. I encourage you to have a look at it after the lecture.
Maybe I'll do it right away.
Ah, the soul of an adventurer gets the upper hand.
Well, I've got a very tight schedule. No time to waste.
Won't you be distracted before the lecture?
Quite the opposite. I'm well prepared, but it'll calm my nerves instead.
Stage fright?
I'm afraid so.
I can assure you that everything is ready. Try not to think about the lecture for a while and just have a look around the building.
Takže máme jít na atrakci pro turisty, no dobrá. To tady opravdu není nic lepšího, co můžeme dělat, třeba koupit si pizzu nebo tak.
Oh, it's magnificent in here. I love Venice.
The former Serenissime is still dazzling. This place used to belong to the Scuola, a confraternity stemming from the middle...
A grand building.
Not as grand as the Scuola Grandi buildings, six of them altogether. This was the unofficial seventh one.
Unofficial?
Yes, for instance, despite its name, there was never a relic of the True Cross in here. The Confraternity of St. John the Evangelist, one of the great six, had it. Those institutions had a large influence over the burghers. Thanks to them, they were not only able to perform, so to speak, statutory tasks, such as helping their brothers and their families, but they also could satisfy the need for prestige and shape the policy of the Republic.
Prestige in Venice had to be pretty expensive.
Oh yes, surely you've heard of the Tintoretto paintings adorning the Scuola Grande di San Rocco.
Naturally, outstanding works.
What about the ravishing interiors of the Scuola Grande di San Marco? The brothers who provided for our building couldn't really equal those, but the architectural concept is similar.
What happened to the Scuola later on?
Well, along with the fall of the Republic, everything started to change. Even the Carnival tradition was relinquished. Do you know who ordered it?
The Inquisition?
Not even close. It was that tyrant, Napoleon, who dissolved the Major Council in 1797. Our society originated from the Scuola in the 19th century, adopting a scientific and cultural character.
At the Maritime Museum, I'm working on a chest that belonged to Ponce de Leon. The director mentioned that it used to be stored here.
Correct. His chest was right there, in the meeting hall.
Can you tell me something more on the subject?
When in 1521 the conquistador died in Havana of a wound inflicted by an Indian arrow, legends about his chest started to circulate. It was said that it contained a map showing the location of the Fountain of Youth.
Whose hands did it fall into?
Views on this matter are divided. Some say Hernando de Soto obtained it. I incline to the hypothesis that De Leon left the chest in Seville. He gave an account of his journey there in front of the clerks from the Casa de Contratación, who prepared guidelines for Spanish sailors.
Was Padrón Real produced there, that famous map?
You're absolutely right. The official and secret master map of the New World.
Does anybody know what happened to the chest then?
Possibly it was on Juan de Austria's ship during the Battle of Lepanto, when he led the Holy League fleet to victory. In the whole commotion, the chest must have ended up on one of the Venetian galleasses participating in the battle.
By coincidence?
Whether by coincidence or deliberately, the Confraternity of the True Cross took it over. The initiated brothers hid it away, since De Austria kept on searching for his lost property. In any case, he wasn't the only one after the legendary map.
It was believed to lead to the Fountain of Youth?
Such were those days. The most ambitious individuals were looking for El Dorado, the Philosopher's Stone, or the Fountain.
And the brothers?
They had prestige. The more they denied having the chest, the greater their prestige was.
And what happened to the chest later on?
They emptied the cache during the Napoleonic Wars. The chest was hastily moved to a different, safer place in the city.
You know where to?
Unfortunately, no. Our guardian Grande, who moved the chest, was murdered soon after.
Huh, what a mysterious story. Have my books arrived?
Yes, they're here. A beautiful edition. They still smell of printing ink and success.
How large an audience do you expect?
I'm certain many people will come. We have our own regular audience, and apart from that, we advertise the lecture as a huge event. You can expect many people.
Thank you for your encouragement.
Relax. Everything will be just perfect, huh?
Certainly. This time, I won't pay the same price for success.
You mean your uncle's death. A much regretted loss. But life has to go on, and your uncle would be so proud of you.
Thank you. I do believe that.
No, uvidíme. Řekl bych, že co nevidět, nám půjde opět o život.
What events have you planned for the immediate future?
A lecture and an exhibition about the birth of the Latin Empire.
Oh, a very interesting topic, and related to the city as well.
That's the point. And then a more exotic series of lectures about Atlantis, from analyzing Plato's dialogues to presenting archaeological finds in the field.
That's debatable.
I know. I'm still preparing the list of lecturers. Perhaps you could help me with it.
I'll think about it and let you know when I'm in France.
I'll be obliged.
May I have a look around the hall?
But of course, please do.
A refined and well-read man. It was a pleasure talking to him.
Ano, kromě něj tady vidím akorát jednoho člověka, který pravděpodobně očumuje náš portrét, který to bude asi reklama naší přednášky. Tak nevím, jak moc velkou účast budeme mít, jo? Jestli tam bude jenom tamhle ten dědula, nebo co to je, tak to teda nic moc. Každopádně máme novou kapitolu, takže bych řekl, že budeme mít i nějaký nové informace. Nejprve se podívám do deníku, teda do dokumentu. Ale tady jsou vlastně jenom znova znázorněny ty věci, které už známe. Ta mapa, dopis, hráběte a tak dále. Takže mě zajímá deník, ano. Shrnutí vlastně minulý kapitoly, Bretaň, leden 2009. Milý deníčku, mám pocit, že jsem součástí nějakého strašidelného příběhu. Zase. Musím dodat, že mi připadá velmi vzrušující, ale po pořadě. Rozbouřené moře podél útesu středověké hradby ošlehané deštěm a větrem. Čas od času jsou mraky tak laskavé, že se odhalí. Hrad na slunci hrdě září. Úžasné, že? Uvnitř těchto hradeb bylo založeno venkovské námořní muzeum. Dohlídá Antoine, holič v důchodu, který přesvědčivě hraje roli starého mořského vlka. A co tu dělám já? Julian, ředitel muzea, mě požádal o znalecký posudek truhly ze 16. století. Nádherná relikvie spojená s dobyvatelem Ponce de Leonem, který objevil Floridu. Člověk, který na tom pracoval předtím? Dobře, stalo se mu něco hrozného. Spadl z útesu blízko hostince. Jmenoval se Marcel a byl Claireův přítel, také restaurátor. Milá žena, ale velmi poznamenaná touto tragédií. Claire mi pomohla najít Marcelovy poznámky, díky kterým se mi podařilo vypořádat s číselným zámkem a dostat se do truhly. Našel jsem tam pistoli z 16. století, francouzský klíč a nabiják. Měla jsem pocit, že mám v hledání pokračovat a měla jsem pravdu. Pod falešným dnem byl skrytý rukopis. Dobyvatel na něm popisuje plavbu z roku 1513, obě Floridy a ostrova Biminy. O tomto ostrově píše podivuhodné věci. Jeho obyvatelé, soustředění kolem obrovského stromu, žili neuvěřitelně dlouho. To je jeden z těch bájných příběhů, který přinutil odvážné lidi odejít neznámo kam. Dobyvatel do rukopisu všil mapu jako důkaz. Bohužel bez jakýchkoliv souřadic. Uvnitř truhly byl i nějaký starý úlomek z keramiky, který Marcel naskenoval a mně se ho podařilo pomocí 3D tiskárny zrekonstruovat. Beru si to sebou, včetně kopie mapy. I když jsem ředitele okouzlila, musím odcestovat na několik dnů do Benátek. Mám tam přednášku, kde propaguji svou knihu o mých objevech na Maltě. U podivu se ukazuje, že osoba, která se o truhlu zajímá, tam na mě bude čekat. Hrabě Saint-Germain. Ta schůzka mě zneklidňuje. Našla jsem dopis od hraběte, psal Marcelovi o té samé věci. Majitel hostince u hradu měl Marcela a nějakého tajemného cizince jako své hosty ten samý večer, kdy Marcel spadl z útesu. Odešli spolu a ztratili se v zuřivé bouři. Marcel zmizel na dobro. Cestou jsem našla v malé škvíře ve vsti a starou minci s emblémem stromu. Možná ji upustil jeden z těch dvou. Nejhorší je, že Claire nevěří, že se Marcel ztratil. Myslí si, že to nebyla nehoda. Ale proč by chtěl někdo zabít restaurátora z venkovského muzea? A vrah může být ten záhadný hrábě, se kterým se mám zítra setkat. No, na setkání jsem zvědavej. Tak se pustíme do nějakého toho pátrání. Máme tady druhou kapitolu, tak uvidíme, co se nám podaří vypátrat. Tamhle ten náš obrázek.
An ad of my book with a lecture agenda.
No, žádná extra sláva to teda asi nebude. Ale skartovačka. To kdyby náhodou ty posluchači měli asi zájem o to si ty knihy okamžitě zbavit, tak aby mohli zlikvidovat.
I'm going to sign my books after the lecture. Let's hope somebody is interested.
O tom dost pochybuju. Ale můžeme si to vzít.
I described my last amazing discovery in it.
Jo, rituál štíra. Štíří rituál Sylvie Leroux a náš portrét. A tím to končí. To je celá knížka. Koda, já jsem myslel, že tam třeba jako bude aspoň k vidění pár stránek, které by popisovaly alespoň jako nějak zhruba, jo, ty události prvního dílu. Bohužel, tak nic, no. Pero. Odlakovač. Lak na nechty, tampon, no ano. Tohle jsem si vždycky strašně přál mít v kapse. Normální plnící pero.
It doesn't only dissolve nail polish.
Ne, fakt ne.
My favorite kind, long lasting and high quality.
Juhu, růžový lak na nechty. A tamponek, jo. Tomu říkám teda výbava správního adventuristy, dobrá, tak fajn. Pojďme se podívat nahoru.
Classical statues, oil paintings and heavy draperies are in stark contrast to the austere stone walls.
Jo, jako je pravda, že to tady je celkem stylový, jo. Celkem jako fajn prostředí.
They weren't painted by a renowned master, but they still represent the good old Venetian school.
Ach jo, ovšem, ta krkolomnost toho překladu. No tak.
I'm curious what they use this trap door for.
Je tu nějaký poklop.
Something's blocking the lid.
Ale nemůžu otevřít, jako by to bylo nějak držený. Je tamhle strašná tma, takže ani nevím, jestli to jsou panty, nebo co to tam drží. Tady je stůl s ubrusem. Tady je docela pěkný stůl, jo? Škoda ubrusu. Teda chci říct, jakože zakrývat ten stůl ubrusem. To podle mě není správný.
Heavy duty linen.
A pak ještě závěs.
A durable curtain. It can take a lot. A strong tie back. It can hold a lot of weight.
To jo. Ten udrží i slona. Možná i dva. Tak to bychom měli projít i patro. Co máme tady dole vlastně?
Venetian lions guard the secrets of the confraternity.
Tamhle nahoře jsou nějaký sochy, ale tam nebylo možné pokračovat. Jakoby vejš. Tak nevím, tam se asi ani nepodíváme. Mohli bychom jít ven.
I've still got a couple of minutes till the meeting with the count. I'll just relish the atmosphere of the city.
No, trošku se projdem, co to bylo. Tady sedí nějaký děda. To jsou nějaký petardy, ne? No jasně, to bude.
Ah, Venice, engulf me in thy endless festivities.
Jo, paráda, no. Tak, to bychom měli, je to krása, opravdu, a tady stojí nějaká osoba v masce. Vedle studny.
The beautiful Venetian wells are a part of the complex rainwater gathering system developed centuries ago. Having a good time?
Ah, oh, jolly good.
To je vše? To bylo teda téma hovoru.
A pretty well. Seems like a perfect spot for an appointment.
I'm a mad because I'm awaiting for my boyfriend, and we have a deal.
What is it?
That I am the one who cannot be laid.
Maybe you've come too early.
Oh, it seems so. But it's all because of this lecture. I want to have a good seat. They say it's going to be crowded.
Really?
Yeah, the canals are already jammed. Some of my friends decided to swim.
And all of that because of some archaeology lecture?
So what? That a woman discovered something anew on a Malta. We Italians are really interested in it.
Amazing.
Why so surprised? Local children dig up ancient coins playing in sandboxes. Where do you think they get the money for famous Italian ice cream, eh?
To vypadá, že to má v té kebuli nějaký pomotaný.
You're wearing a lovely dress.
I sewed it myself.
You did? I envy you. I need to wear this suit.
Why is that?
That's what my stylist suggested, and now I don't even have anything to change into. Wearing a suit in the middle of the carnival.
I'm gonna try to find something in the wardrobe. I am a set designer in a theater. But you know what? You look good to me.
Thanks. Have fun.
Thanks. You too.
Opravdu povedený rozhovor. Říkám si, co mě to jako mělo přinést. Možná, že hrabat se v odpadkovém koši pro nás bude užitečnější. Je tam nějaký smetí, ale jinak tam nic nevidím. Tak asi ne. To je divný. Můžeme jít na most.
Not a soul in sight. Have they all run to St. Mark's Square?
No, vypadá to, že moc velkou pozornost na té přednášce mít nebudeme. Ale takový benátský kanál, typický, jo, to je prima. Ovšem, ne když se tam povalujou odpadky. Špína, smrad, špinavá zatuchlá voda a tak dále.
Taxi! It's no use.
Tady to na taxíka si nevypadá.
On a night like this, the taxi stand is deserted.
Navíc nevím, jestli se na gondoliniera volá taxi. To asi ne. Tak snad abychom šli opět dovnitř. Pojďme se teda podívat vedle. Omrkneme tam ten podivný nápis a uvidíme, třeba něco zjistíme. Trošku moc židlí, jo. Myslím si, že ta jedna řada by úplně stačila, ty ostatní by mohli s klidem uklidit.
Colorful stained glass windows add luster to the austere interior.
Je to strohý, ale stylový. Náhodou, mně se to tu líbí.
The interior was furnished this way, so as not to distract the audience.
No, to rozhodně ne. Jsou tu nějaké vitrínky?
The exhibition of archaeological tools from a bygone era will complement my lecture.
Teda, tam je věcí. Dláto, štěteček, nějaká lupa, nějaký konzervy. Ty asi nebudou sídlem.
The showcase is closed.
Ale nedá se to otevřít, to je škoda. Chtělo by to klíč. A co ta druhá?
The organizer decided to enrich the lecture with a small thematic exhibition.
Au, kladívko, to bych chtěl.
The showcase is closed.
Škoda, no tak nic, no. Tak nevím, sice je pravda, že už jednu stránku inventáře máme plnou, ale přijde mi, že tady potkáváme nějak hodně jako míst, kde by mohly být nějaký věci, ale nejsou tam. Tohle bude ten výklanek. Ale žebřík, to je moc vysoký. Jo, ještě že se nám vešel do kapsy.
I'd like to look at it closely, but it's simply too high for me.
Jsou tam opravdu nějaký desky, ale bude to chtít ten žebřík.
There's a mystery hidden in this chaotic inscription. Maybe I should make a fancy digression on it while delivering the lecture. The inscription pieces just need to be rearranged.
To vypadá na takovou tu posunovací skládačku. Ale to bychom tady museli mít jedno místo prázdný. Jasně. Tak jo, jdeme na to. Vypadá to, že tam je nějaký nápis, takže neskládáme podle obrázku, ale podle nápisu. To by mohlo být složitější. Fajn. Tak, jdeme dál. Teďka by to chtělo vzít spíš po sloupcích. Akorát ještě nevím, co tam vlastně přijde. Teďka už by to nemělo být žádný problém.
I think it's the confraternity's maxim. Ugh, I heard a grind. It gives me the creeps. The bases of the columns turned slightly. Oh, you can rotate them.
Fakt? A jo. Otáčíš to tou deskou, něco tam je. Ale asi se to musí nějak urovnat, aby to šlo prozkoumat.
Well done, Sylvie. You've opened it. With such security, there must be something precious inside.
No, něco tu teda je, ale upřímně čekal bych víc, jo. Nějaký semínka.
There was only a handful of dry seeds inside. I think they traveled here inside the conquistador's chest over 400 years ago.
Jo, tak co si z nich vypěstujem? Palmu?
A handful of dry, unusually shaped seeds.
Tak nevím. Asi budou ty semínka nějak vzácný, ale nechápu proč. Nějaký týpek.
Miss Sylvie Leroux.
That's me.
Count Saint-Germain asked me to have a brief word with you.
The Count was supposed to meet me in person.
Not this time.
He asked for the meeting himself. I'm disappointed.
The Count will call you.
He won't come?
He is afraid of a few obtrusive acquaintances.
Who are you, really? A gondolier, a messenger, or the Count's associate?
Two of these names are correct.
Shall I guess?
How about a compromise? You won't be guessing, and I won't be answering. Anyway, I need to go.
Wait a second. Tell me something about Saint Germain.
In a word?
A sentence would be fine.
Mysterious.
And that's all?
No. I've brought something extraordinary for you.
What is it? A chronometer?
Take a look at it. The Count is curious about your opinion.
Am I to examine it?
If possible.
All right, but not today. I'm delivering a lecture. This death. It's horrible. I'm still shocked by what happened. It could have been me. Everything is lost.
There was no other way. I had to cancel the lecture.
For this young man.
Unfortunately. Such a tragedy.
Did he have any family?
Everyone does.
A wife? A child?
The police haven't identified him yet, but he's a local, a gondolier.
Somebody out there is worrying about him.
I'll ask around tomorrow, but the carnival is no time for mourning.
A woman is waiting to criticize him for being so late. In a few hours, she'll be willing to forgive him anything as long as he returns.
Instead of him, an embarrassed police officer will come and inform her in a cold voice that...
Everything is lost.
No, not for her.
And the Count? Is he waiting for him? Isn't he curious about the impression he's made with the chronometer?
Do you have the Count's phone number?
No, nothing. I can only wait. I don't really know what for.
You should go to bed.
No way. I wouldn't be able to fall asleep to protect myself from everything that happened here. Barely 2 hours ago.
A few sleeping pills will take care of that.
And I was so surprised that my uncle needed to take them.
You're young. You'll recover quickly. A bit of sleep and the body itself will deal with the tormented mind.
No, tak řekl bych, že to nějak jako nevyšlo podle představ, jo? Ale zase na druhou stranu nebude to taková ostuda, protože tohle to určitě přiláká daleko víc čtenářů, jo? Nebo prostě těch diváků, ty přednášky. Sice se bude muset odložit, ale potom se určitě přijdou podívat na přednášku v místě, kde došlo před pár dny k vraždě. Jasně, akorát nechápu, proč ten Fantomas, nebo co to bylo... Netrefil tu naši hrdinku, jako jo. To skoro vypadá, že oni nechtějí, aby umřela ona. Ale likvidou lidi, kteří nějak jsou napojeni na to, hráběte. On tam hodil tu minci a to je stejná mince, jakou jsme našli na útesu. Potkať skákal Marcel bungee jumping bez provazu. Takže to vypadá, že opravdu jejich cílem je hrábě. Ale proč?
Not so long ago, a man with good intentions shot my uncle. Probably by chance. I believe that.
I read about that tragedy.
People are like houses in a medieval city. When one collapses, the ones close to it start shaking.
With all due respect, the death of an old man isn't as depressing as that of a young one. How old do you think he was?
Still, you can say that my uncle didn't die in vain. Something was saved back then. But why did the gondolier die?
Maybe somebody was settling an old score. A jealous husband, perhaps?
Anyway, it doesn't make sense. I'm still wondering if it wasn't me he wanted to kill.
No, the killer had enough time to shoot again.
Maybe he panicked.
From what you said, it appears he was self-confident and not in a hurry at all.
That strange missile, the Curare poisoned arrow, almost grazed me.
But you're safe now. I guess that's why you refuse to have any police protection.
You're right. I just need to focus on something. That chronometer he gave me.
Do you have it?
Please don't give me away. I don't want the police to take it.
There's always time for that.
I'll take care of the chronometer. After all, it was his... What was his name?
I don't know.
His last wish. The chronometer needs to be cleaned, and I've seen various reagents and tools in that showcase in the meeting hall. May I use them?
But how? The hall is sealed and we can't enter.
True. Then I can't do anything, can I?
I'd like to get inside myself. I left my documents on a chair. God knows when I'll gain access to them.
They sealed it and left it just like that? And we're supposed to wait until they generously let us in?
Well, force majeure.
What if we unstuck the tape, took everything we needed, and then stuck it back?
You'd better not do that. You'd put yourself in trouble.
I'll do it in such a way that nobody will notice.
I doubt that's possible.
You don't believe me. I'm an archaeologist, and restoration is my work.
But you'll destroy the tape.
No, I won't. I need to think it over in private.
I won't disturb you.
The gondolier asked me to check the watch. I guess I should do that.
No tak dobrá. Ale nejprve teda chci vidět ten slavný chronometr.
A 19th century watch with an openable watch case. There's an engraving under the layer of dirt. Maybe I could use the reagents from that showcase to help me read the inscription.
Jo, něco tady opravdu je, nějaký jakoby možná nápis, ale čitelný to teda není ani náhodou. Dobrá, takže zkusíme to nějak otevřít, nebo případně bychom se mohli podívat ven. Jelikož uběhlo několik hodin, tak je možný, že se to tady poněkud změnilo.
Když... I'm coming here.
Hey.
Jo. Už to jsou dva blázni.
Hi, how are you doing?
Great, aren't we, Bianca?
We are not. It was great when you decided to dive into the empathy fountain.
Everybody keeps saying that. But I actually don't remember any of it.
Arnolfo all over. So absent-minded.
What are you doing tonight?
Tonight is going to be cultural. First, the archaeology lecture. Then, a conversation with the speaker. Several glasses of free wine.
An autograph, a photo together.
Then some free wine again.
Going to a restaurant with a newly met friend.
A chance for more glasses of free wine.
An unexpected encounter with some old friends.
Time to switch to whole bottles.
An unavoidable visit to the familiar ATM.
And then we go the whole hog.
Or vaulting the canal.
You haven't learned your lesson? You've already forgotten how you got stuck in the middle of the canal, hanging on an upright oar.
Oh, I wasn't stuck. That was my strategy.
No matter how many times you try, you'll never repeat that.
We'll see about that. We'll see.
Yeah, unless some gondolier helps you.
Oh, you'd be surprised. The older the gondolier, the harder the oar.
So, how do you like our agenda for tonight?
Very ambitious.
Yeah, nothing a doing. Item one, off the list.
No free glasses of wine.
Only one thing on your mind. No feast for the soul. They've cancelled the lecture.
How could they turn their backs on their loyal audience?
Na to si myslíte jenom zdá, kdo to vymýšlí takový dialogy. Hruza, já už se s ním ani nechci dal bavit, no? Ale asi budu muset.
A murder with...
A murder? What happened?
You could say somebody was shot.
Horrible!
I told you I saw the police.
You also came here for the lecture?
Yeah.
Then join us.
I can't. I've got an appointment at the...
Oh, a priest?
No, just an appointment.
Oh, don't worry. Maybe something will come of it.
Goodbye.
See you in the city.
Bye. You'll find us in the last open of John.
Tipsy, but a funny couple anyway. I'd like to have fun like them. There's another masquerader on the bridge. I'll go talk to him. Figure on the bridge makes my skin crawl.
A sakra, to je ten Fantomas. Se tam asi nedostanem, nebo jo?
That figure on the bridge makes my skin crawl.
No, znamená to zřejmě, že ne.
The facade, just like the interior, is an interesting combination of architectural styles.
Během rozhovoru s těma dvoma pochybnýma typama jsem si všim, že z toho koše kouká nějaká pruhovaná páska, nebo co to bylo. No jasně. A už je tu flaška. A tady nějaká krabička. Hele, hele, kleště. Lůžky. A to je všechno. Nic víc tu asi už není. No vidím. Vybírat popelnice se vyplatí.
Tough plastic tape.
Policejní páska, ta se nám bude hodit.
It'll come in handy. I won't burn my hands.
Nespálit ruce, jako z čeho? Jako z chlastu? No z tohohle bych teda nechtěl pít ani omyl. Prostě kleště.
Blunt, but pointed.
Prostě nůžky, no jo, no. Mimochodem, tak mě napadá, že je to hloupost. Nechtěli by tu knížku, když se tak těšili na tu přednášku. Asi to znamená, že ne. Nebo?
Too bad. Nobody to write a dedication for.
No tak nic. Žádný věnování teda nebude.
There's an empty gondola by the scola wall. The question is, how to get on it.
Jo, to bude gondola toho mrtvýho. Jenomže je trošku daleko. Jde se teda věnovat té pásce.
I shouldn't be tearing this tape off. It's punishable by law.
No, tak nic. Možná bychom ji mohli nějak odlepit.
Men always wonder why we need to carry so much stuff around in our bags, but they can't deal with simple tasks like these.
Aha, to bylo teda vtipný. Tamhle se valala mrtvola. Pojďme se na to podívat zblízka. Bylo to přímo tady. Stopa 1, stopa 2, tam ale nic není, to je divný. Hele, tohle bude ta mince.
I found a similar coin in Brittany. Is the murderer leaving his mark? I already have two ancient gold coins with the emblem of a tree. Both are connected with dramatic events.
Ty penízky jsou víceméně stejný. Říkám si, že by se asi dali dobře prodat do nějakého starožitnictví. Ale asi nám to ten vrahoun nehodil proto, abychom z toho vydělali peníze. A tady budou ty dokumenty toho chlápka pořadatele.
He should be grateful I've recovered them.
Rozkoumat je ale nemůžeme, škoda. No a teďka bych rád ty věci z té vitríny, jenomže...
The showcase is closed.
No jo, ona je přece pořád zamčená. Bychom se tam museli vloupat, kdyby to šlo, jo, to rozbít. Ale mám takový pocit, že nám to hra nedovolí.
I found your documents, but I can't open the showcases without the keys.
I'm grateful for the documents. Just a second, here, the...
Thank you. I need to think it over in private.
I won't disturb you.
A máme tu klíče.
With this bunch of keys, I can search every corner of the skola.
Jo, klíče od všeho možného. Dva starožitný, to byl nějakým dveřím, anebo k té vitríně. A jeden, ten skoro vypadá, jako by byl od auta. Výborně. Tak, co si z toho vezmem? Nejradši bych bral všechno.
Archaeological tools. They still look quite useful to me.
Wow, teda, to jsem nečekal. Ale dobrý, jo, fajn. Máme hromadu věcí, tak ještě vybrakujem tu druhou.
Unfortunately, the key doesn't fit.
Aha, tak to je zrada. No dobře, tak podíváme se, co jsme tu vlastně objevili.
Archaeologists use such brushes to sweep the dust from unearthed items.
Štěteček, jasně. Modrá prachovka. Čištění. Tříbra. Fajn. Patina.
This indispensable tool can also be useful for restoration work.
No jo, anebo když chcete postavit zeď.
A magnifying glass can be very helpful for analyzing the finds in detail.
A je to. Dobrá, takže začneme tím. Že. Potřebujeme nějak zrestaurovat ten nápis na těch hodinkách. Tak možná by to chtělo nějak vyčistit.
This won't work.
Ne? Dobrá. Tak tam hodíme patinu a čistit budeme jinak.
Think, Sylvie, think.
Škoda. Jaké to zklamání. Máme tady ten ubrus, ale to by nám asi jako čistidlo moc jako nepomohlo. Ovšem tampon, tak by měl být víceméně dokonalý na to. Fajn. Myslím, že jsme připraveni.
I can see an inscription, but it's soiled and I can't read it. I think I've cleaned it too hard. I can't decipher the inscription.
Ale no tak, to se vyčistí.
Now I need to gently remove the patina.
To vypadá to hůř než předtím, jo? Ale budeme doufat, že se to podaří.
The inscription is clear now, but the letters are too small for me to read. A 19th century watch with an inscription.
No vidá, už se tam dá něco přečíst, ale opravdu nerozluším to. Takže pojďme se na to podívat zblízka.
Mary Celeste, 1872, Benjamin Spooner Briggs. This chronometer belonged to the captain of the abandoned ship.
Wow, slavná loď duchů.
There are two engravings on the watch case. Mary Celeste, 1872, and Benjamin S. Briggs.
To je zajímavý. Dodnes se vlastně vedou spekulace o tom, co se na té lodi muselo přihodit.
Here are the keys. I've taken some tools and reagents from the showcase.
Use them for as long as you please.
Thank you so much.
Have you stuck the tape back on the door?
No, s tou páskou, nechtěl by to udělat on?
Ah, the tape.
Yes, you'd better do it right away.
I've deciphered the inscriptions. You'll never believe who this chronometer belonged to.
Not to Ponce de Leon.
You're joking, and it really is interesting.
So whose chronometer was it?
There are two inscriptions, Benjamin S. Briggs and Mary Celeste, 1872.
My, that's no mean treat.
As you know, the captain along with the whole crew of Mary Celeste vanished without a trace in 1872.
Yes, if I remember correctly, on 4 December, the drifting ship was spotted in the Atlantic by the De Grazia crew, about 400 miles off the coast of Gibraltar.
Everything on board was almost in perfect order, but they couldn't find any crew members. That must have been quite a spooky experience.
This mystery hasn't been solved up to this day, although various theories have been put forward.
None of them able to explain the mystery.
Did you know that a few years earlier, Briggs had come to Europe, to Marseille reputedly, though I've heard a hypothesis that to Italy as well.
In any case, his chronometer reached as far as Venice. The captain might have left it on the ship.
I know nothing about it, but it seems that the personal belongings disappeared along with their owners.
This means that Briggs didn't take it on the journey, and that's quite strange.
This whole story is strange.
Because of this whole confusion, I've forgotten to tell you I found a cache underneath the Latin inscription in the recess.
The cache where the conquistador's chest was kept?
It seems so. It was empty, apart from a few seeds.
I also almost forgot to tell you something. Among the documents you've brought me from the meeting hall, there's a list of contents of that chest.
From the times when it was stored here?
Yes, the list comes from the 16th century.
So what's on the list?
Uvedená truhla, chráněná jejím opatrovníkem, je zhruba 20 palců dlouhá. Je vyrobena z palisandrového dřeva, její stěny jsou bohatě zdobené stříbrnými růžicemi. Má 3 kovové číselníky spojené se zámkem, umístěné na výku, které je posílené ozdobnou deskou. Obsahuje pistoli, nabiják a francouzský klíč, co mají pořád s tím klíčem. Džbán zhotovený z řeckého jílu, ozdobený ve stylu kréckého hrnčířství, s 2 chrliči otočenými každý na jinou stranu. No, my z toho džbánu máme jenom kousíček. To ještě je vytištěný na tiskárně. Truhla patřila Juanu Ponce de Leonovi, bývalému guvernérovi Portorika a objeviteli Floridy.
There's one thing I didn't find in the chest.
Namely?
A uniquely shaped jug, if I got it right. That's correct. There was a pottery fragment in the chest. A spout of a jug, to be precise.
It's possible that the damaged jug has been traveling around the world for some time. I've heard that someone from Cairo bought it.
Can you give me any details?
None, I'm afraid. Some people protect such information like intelligence secrets, and this is one of those cases.
Tough luck. Maybe the auction house will know something. You know what? Now that the chest was found, maybe it's worth exhibiting it again in the place it had been kept for so many years.
A terrific idea. We could combine it with a scientific symposium. For instance, the role of legends in the discovery and conquest of the New World.
I'll help you. I'll talk to the museum director. For the time being, however, a lot of strenuous work on that chest awaits me.
I'm looking forward to the results. You can share them when you give a lecture during the exhibition in the Scuola di Santa Croce.
I'd love to. Although, I'm still shivering when I think of today's events.
A man called. He wanted to talk to you.
Did he introduce himself?
No, but he'll call you again.
I need to think it over in private.
I won't disturb.
Hello, Sylvie Leroux speaking.
Count Saint-Germain. I intended to come there, but under the circumstances...
So you know.
Bad news spreads quickly.
What about his family?
Family? I do not know them. I cannot talk for long, therefore let me come to the point. I would like to commission you to do an expert analysis for me. It is crucial. Please take the tools and reagents with you.
What reagents? What am I going to analyze?
A painted plank. Please bring anything you find. Have you got the chronometer?
Yes, he gave it to me just before his death.
Then bring it as well, regardless of whether you have managed to examine it or not.
I have.
Really? Splendid. Please come to me as soon as possible.
And the address?
You will find it on the chronometer.
On the chronometer, but I checked it carefully. There's no address.
But there is. If what they say about you is true, you will know how to reach me.
I'm not so sure of that.
I cannot say anything more. This telephone might be tapped, after all. Do be careful. If you have the impression that someone is following you, turn back. Be alert.
I've almost gotten killed today. How about putting it off till tomorrow? It'll be much safer.
On the contrary, tomorrow we may not have the chance to meet.
Okay, I'll try.
Just remember not to discuss the matter with anyone, not even in the squalor.
Fine.
I am awaiting you.
I need to see this man, if only to return the chronometer. In fact, I can't wait to meet him. So the pottery fragment I've copied is the spout of the jug which was kept inside the chest from the 16th century.
No, tak to je teda výborný. Máme jít zkoumat prkno. Fajn. Nejdřív teda začneme tím, že zkusíme nějak vrátit do původního stavu tu pásku tady na těch dveřích.
This won't work.
No jo, musíme to nějak přilepit. Lepidlem nebo něčím takovým. Lakem.
At first glance, everything looks normal, and the first impression does matter.
No, dobrá. Doufám, že tam už opravdu nebudeme muset jít.
See for yourself. The police will never notice anything.
Unbelievable.
I know my stuff.
You really are a professional.
I need to think it over in private.
I won't disturb you.
Tak, jenomže co teď? Musíme zjistit, jak se dostaneme k tomu hráběti. Jenomže na mostě stojí Fantomas. Jak to provedeme?
Have you heard of the Casa Celeste?
You mean Palazzo Celeste?
Palazzo.
You've got to go down the canal.
Straight, turn right, turn left, turn right twice.
Turn right four times.
You want her to go around in circles?
That'd be fun, huh? Hold on, what's your name?
Sylvie.
Like that archaeologist.
But you know, it will be hard for you to catch an empty gondola.
The boats are overcrowded.
Unless you board the Vampiretto.
You can try the drowning style.
You jump from the bridge when a gondola passes by. The passengers start screaming, the gondolier pulls you on board.
Does it work?
Not worth trying. The canal water stinks awful.
I know. A water segway would be ideal for Sylvie.
You can do various sports here. A bath in winter isn't the best idea.
Je to vůbec možný? Pro ještě chvilku a já z těch příšerných dialogů snad chytím rakovinu nebo něco.
Oh, poor archaeologist.
Which one?
The one dead that was supposed to give the lecture.
One more drink and she'll be back to normal.
Why poor?
Haven't you heard? She was shot.
No, it wasn't her.
Going to promote her book.
Maybe it was a disappointed reader, eh? Instead of buying a computer game, he spent all of his money on a piece of paper.
A lunatic.
Only lunatics shoot the people. Maybe it was a reviewer, eh?
He was preparing to go to a match when his editor told him to write an urgent review of a popular science book.
He must have been a crime story specialist. Since he knew how to handle a gun, but that book he couldn't handle, so he did the only thing he could. Bing!
He didn't know that you don't shoot a piano player.
Listen, that woman is alive.
That's great news.
Was she a rescue?
Somebody else was killed, a gondolier.
I had a feeling we wouldn't catch a taxi tonight.
Explain it to me, Bianca. Why would a reviewer shoot a gondolier?
Would you read such a book?
So, a gondolier was a writer too?
No. Would you buy the book instead of a game?
Me? Of course. I'd buy it and ask her to sign it for me.
Ah, yeah, right. I know you. You'd be flirting with her.
I'd invite her out for a free glass of wine.
Haven't you heard she was barely rescued? What if you're drinking a free wine with her? And suddenly a reviewer appears and bang!
I'd rescue her.
Do you even realize what it would mean to be responsible for her life?
Teda, ale no to začíná vypadat, že oni opravdu by chtěli tu knížku s autogramem. Třeba potom přestanou tak šíleně blábolit.
I've taken a life-saving course. I'd give her a heart massage, a mouth-to-mouth.
Ah,
Well, foot massage would be best.
What?
What kind of a lifesaver are you if you don't know what the map of the whole body is on the feet, eh? You wouldn't have to brutally press her heart.
Chest?
Your lecher. She's already experienced enough violence. You can find her heart area on her foot and gently press it with your thumbs. Slowly.
Ah, that's exactly how I'm going to rescue her.
Well, I'll show you where it is. Sylvie, I can't. Maybe you could show it to him, eh?
You know what? I'll get that book with an autograph for you. Just wait a moment.
Cool. But don't worry if it doesn't work out. Three glasses of wine will do.
Remember not to badger the lady. She's barely been rescued. She deserves some rest.
Yes, she will.
Goodbye.
See you in the city.
Bye. You'll find us in the last open joint.
To je naprosto děsivé, to je adventurní dnos, to snad není možný, jo, kdo to vymýšlel, tenhle ten dialog. No nic, dobrá. Potřebujeme knížku, podepsanou, žádný problém.
I'll sign this secretly so that they don't know I'm the author. After what happened, I better keep a low profile.
Dobrá, tak to teda nebudeme podepisovat přímo před nima. Budeme na to radši dovnitř. Nebo aspoň sem, to by snad mohlo stačit.
Perfect for newly met archaeology fans.
To jo. Pro Bianku i, nebo co to je, Arnolfa, opravdové milovníky archeologie. No to jo. Doufám, že se budete stále bavit, doufám, že ne.
I've got the book for you, with the dedication.
To Bianca and Arnolf, true archaeology lovers, I hope you'll always feel like having fun. Sylvia LaRoe.
Beautiful.
You've done a terrific job, girl. But you know what? I have a feeling we should thank the author in person.
I really think she's been through way too much today.
Arnie, I know you're a wonderful lifesaver, but let's not tempt fate.
All right. So what are we going to do with such a promising night?
I'm certain you'll be just fine. I've got to go my own way.
Sylvie, once you've talked long enough, take him out to the city. You won't regret that.
I don't know if he'll be willing to.
Arnie, don't push her. She isn't sure of the guy yet. Sylvie, since you're having this, can't be so demonstrative, eh?
It's not a tryst.
Every decent Venetian girl wears a mask when going to a tryst. Take it. Without the mask, you're conspicuously naked.
You just stand out.
Thanks.
Takže máme masku, no výborně. To nestačí rouška?
Oh, and one more thing. I call this the Baron Munchausen trick, eh? If a guy turns out to be a worthless yet pestering, grab the flame, administer it, and then light it. You'll get rid of him in no time.
Aren't you going a bit too far? The girl may take it literally.
Ah, stop your whining. I love you because you're so crazy. And now, we needed to do something for Sylvia Love.
What do you mean?
I have a hunch that she is very sad and I can't do anything about it for now. That's why we need to have a great time, eh?
Goodbye.
See you in the city.
Bye. You'll find us in the last open joint.
Oh, ne, už nikdy a nikde. To jsme to vlastně dostali.
Some cheap plastic on your face and you're a completely different person.
Takhle hnus.
Another prop of a self-taught pyrotechnist.
No, ruční granát by byl užitečnější, ale dobře, no, aspoň něco. Jenomže ani tak netuším, co s tím budeme vlastně podnikat. My se musíme nějak dostat na tu gondolu, jenomže ta je v tom kanálu trošku daleko. Jak to províst?
As a child, I used to make smoke bombs out of table tennis balls. That was fun.
Udělat dýmovnici? To zní jako docela náročný úkol. No dobře, tak... jde to zkusit.
The flare is ready to be completed with something.
Tak, světlice je otevřená. Teď by to tam chtělo něco nasypat. Co nám udělá oblak dýmu. Ale co by to asi tak mohlo být? Semínka? No, to asi těžko. Taky tady je ta skartovačka. Totiž... abychom nechali skartovat ten seznam, to asi ne. Ale mohli bychom zlikvidovat tu hnusnou masku.
Well, maybe it's a waste, but I wouldn't party today anyway. These strips, however, might come in handy.
Dobře, takže teďka můžeme ty kousky plastu nacpat do té naší dýmovnice.
This could give a lot of smoke. The smoke screen's ready.
No už to začíná vypadat trošku k světu, ale co s tím uděláme dál? Mělo by to nějak zapálit. Ale asi to nebudeme zapalovat tady a navíc čím to zapálíme. No nevím. Každopádně je tu ještě jedna věc, na kterou jsem málem zapomněl, a to je tenhle ten poklop. No to vypadá, že ho něco blokuje, protože...
Something's blocking the lid.
Nemůžeme to otevřít, ale možná by to šlo nějak... s tím províst. A vida. No tak.
Too heavy. I can't hold it.
No, bychom to mohli nějak zapřít, nebo to s něčím svázat. Jo, s oknem. Tam dole vidím dokonce tu loď. Výborně.
No way. I'm not going to jump into the canal.
Ale no tak, vždyť nám to radili ty dva týpci. No tak nic, no tak ale jak to teda provedem?
It's not a great idea.
Mohli bychom prostě seskočit dolů na ty schody. Nebo jestli je to moc vysoko, tak bychom tam mohli třeba sešplhat.
The curtain itself is too short to use as a rope.
Máme tady ještě ubrus.
A great strong rope.
Jo. Červeno-bílý lano, paráda. Je to stylový. Ovšem v té animačce je jenom červený. Ale ne, tam dole je taky kus bílej.
Gee, it even sparkled. The man on the bridge will see me leaving, and the Count asked me to be cautious.
Takže mohli bychom odjet. Tady jsou nějaký dveře.
Locked. I can't get inside.
No, ale možná to už ani nebude potřeba, ne? Naskočíme a jedem.
Broken. I can't row with something like that.
Oh, sakra. Klíček, nějaký divný držák, polštářek a zápalky.
It's good for nothing. Too short.
To je špatný.
There must be a door that it would fit.
No to budou určitě ty dveře tam nahoře. A pak máme hromadu syrek. Fajn. Tady ještě něco. Nějaká dlouhá hůl. Možná bychom ji mohli použít místo vesla. Musíme nejprve odemknout. O, je, to jsme tady. No jo, my jsme vlezli tím tady za závěsem dveřma. No tak, jsme se ale moc nepomohli, pojďme zpátky. Zkusíme dát dokupy to veslo. Já bychom to mohli prostě svázat.
It's falling apart.
No jo, musíme to ještě něčím přivázat. Policejní veslo.
I fixed the oar. Maybe it's no good for ore vaulting the canal, but I can move the boat with it.
No, vypadá to dost chlorově, ale třeba to bude opravdu fungovat. Tak, ale pořád to není tak úplně ono. My patrně nebudeme moci jet, dokud se nějak nezbavíme toho chlápka, toho fantomase na mostě. A to použijem tu dýmovnici, to je jasný, ale... Co nám ještě chybí? Kdybychom... Jo, tu bude hotová bomba.
A smoke bomb ready to be lit.
No, jasně.
No can do.
Jak to? Podle mě by to mělo zabrat.
Trial and error, they say.
Jasně. Hodíme to do toho držáku. No? A je to. Můžeme zapálit.
See, I reached Palazzo Celeste without any mishap.
Výborně. Taky by nám ten hrábě ale mohl otevřít tu mříž.
Because of this portcullis, the room at the far end is inaccessible.
No, to je výborný. Je tu řetěz.
A cast iron chain. Probably a part of the portcullis lifting mechanism.
Je nahoře nějaký hadr... Ne. Počkat, to je kámen.
You can see the palace is dilapidated.
Co je tohle? Zvonkohra?
What a unique gong. Must be an antique.
O sakra, to vypadá na číselný kód.
Is the gate code displayed here?
Ale nemůžu jít na slepo. Číselný kód, čtyřmístnej. Moment.
There are two engravings on the watch case. Mary Celeste 1872 and Benjamin S. Briggs.
On nám říkal, že na tom chronometru je jeho adresa. Tak co kdyby to bylo právě tohle číslo? 1872. To asi správně, ale nějak to nefunguje. Možná to bude tím šutrákem tam nahoře.
We need an alternative solution.
Ne? To je poměrně smutné. Já si myslím, že ten šutrák musíme nějak dostat pryč.
You can see the palace is dilapidated. The stone blocking the mechanism has fallen down. What a bizarre orangery. Such a mystical atmosphere. There's someone sitting on the pedestal, like a ruler on a throne. I suppose that's Count Saint Germain.
No, nebudeme spěchat na to, abychom ho viděli. Vypadá to tady opravdu zvláštně, jak v nějaký podivný džungli.
The humidity in the garden has ruined the sculptures. The plants have really good growing conditions here.
Voda.
We need an alternative solution.
Konec. Nějaká miska. Mohli bychom do konve nabrat vodu.
An old rusty bowl. However, it's not yet eaten away by rust.
Jo.
I don't feel like gardening, but some water could come in handy.
Až budeme mít žízeň, bude se hodit rozhodně. Tu ještě něco. Je to tu celkem tmavý, ale myslím si, že tu nic nevidím. Jsou nějaký kořínky, nebo co to je? Hele, rukavice.
The gloves don't look new, but they're in one piece.
Who?
Who?
Who took his life?
I didn't see him. The killer disappeared, just vanished into thin air.
Oh, was it a ghost?
I feel sorry for you, but why are you blaming me? I could have been killed myself.
It is not about you at all. So many hours have passed, and yet we know nothing. Have the police joined the festivities?
You'll learn nothing from the police. The only thing they're good at is asking the same questions on and on and on.
Those lily-livered assassins trouble and harass me. They want to drive me insane.
Why is that?
If only I could see the murderer's face. Then I would probably understand it.
You'd better not get the chance.
They want me to be afraid of my own shadow. They want my brain to boil with fear. But enough of that. I have not even welcomed you properly. I am Count Saint-Germain.
Sylvie Leroux.
You look even prettier than in the picture.
Teda ten hrábě, ten má taky dost. Co to tady je za bordel, jako jo, a on v tom bydlí.
Here you are, Briggs Chronometer.
Did I hear you right? Briggs?
Yep, Benjamin Spooner Briggs.
Aha!
Was the captain of the ship Mary Celeste, which on 4 November 1872 left...
New York, and a month later was found abandoned 400 miles from Gibraltar.
Have you been testing me?
You've done a splendid job.
Glad to hear that.
No, samozřejmě, že to byl test. Vidíť to, co bylo na tom chronometru, ten letopočet, to byl kód. Tý bráně, takže jako bez toho bychom se sem nedostali.
What's next?
Let us focus on the discovery of Marie Celeste, shall we? They got on board, the captain, what was his name?
David Morehouse?
Morehouse. He boarded the empty ship, not a soul in sight.
The tea was still warm.
Nonsense. A few thousand miles is enough to cool the tea properly.
A few thousand? Why such a theory?
Why not, I say? Just look at what we have here. Escaping the ship because the alcohol they were transporting was about to explode. Pirates, tsunami, and a cook who poisoned the crew and then jumped overboard. How many scribblers have fed on this?
Má trošku bujnou fantazii, takhle to rozhodně nebylo.
No one has solved the mystery of Mary Celeste so far.
This chronometer.
This chronometer what?
It brings us closer to the solution. And undeniably at that.
I'm all ears, Count.
It was not found on the ship.
It wasn't? Briggs left it in New York?
I should rather say in Marion, where he lived. But no, nothing of this kind. The captain had it with him during the voyage.
So Briggs survived? It was all a hoax? Was he trying to swindle compensation?
He should have obeyed his wife and founded that ironmongery in New Bedford. He would not have lost the unblemished reputation he had in his lifetime.
You're right. That man would never stoop to fraud.
I agree. As for the chronometer, it has been a part of my collection for a long time.
Ten podvod, to už je daleko věrohodnější teorie. Jo, jako skutečně, to se celkem jako nabízí, jako reálná možnost.
How did you manage to get the chronometer?
A peculiar case indeed. I cannot tell you how it fell into my hands.
Cannot or will not?
I simply do not remember. My memory fell to tiny pieces, each of which rolled in a different direction.
I'm not really following.
I had an accident. I barely survived a plane crash.
No, vypadá to, že jako by byl po nehodě, to je pravda. Možná spíš duševní. Nepraštil se do hlavy?
I'm sorry about the accident.
Do not be. To tell the truth, after the accident, I was convinced that immortality was something natural.
In a hospital? What a paradox.
Precisely. The particle containing this piece of information drifted far, far away. Too bad it came back again.
If I understand you correctly, you suffer from amnesia. Then how did you get home?
Bloodsuckers always find a host. Fortunately, I am rich. Otherwise, no one would have showed up.
Hezký přirovnání. Pijavice.
Why did you want to see me?
I possess an object, a precious one, I suppose. But this can only be verified by someone like you, a professional.
Where is it?
It is the plank lying on the table. The cracked paint that you see on its surface might be covering an authentic sign or an inscription.
I'll do my best. May I use the things I need?
Everything here is at your disposal.
I'm going back to work.
I hope to talk to you soon.
No, tak jo, budeme zkoumat brkno.
What to think of him? A charismatic person, but marked by suffering. An equally lush garden stretches outside the window.
Je uprostřed nějaký podivný kruh.
Interesting floor decoration, but the pattern on the rings is chaotic.
Je tam nějaký relief? Vypadá to, jako by to byl nějaký strom.
There's a fragment missing in the center.
Ale.
It's not a great idea.
Kdyby to chtělo najít ten zbývající kousek. A pak tady jsou nějaký čtyři dlaždice. Ale nic podivného na nich nevidím.
A master of the Venetian school kept in such conditions?
Jo, chtělo by to tady uklidit. Tady to bude asi to prkno.
A bunch of junk.
Fajn. Kartáč, ten beru. Plechovku beru taky. Plouch, no paráda. To je asi tak všecko, co tady můžeme vzít.
An old brush, useful for scrubbing. A can containing lye-resistant polyvinyl acetate. A container with lye, a highly caustic substance. Though the plank doesn't look interesting, there might be something extraordinary under the cracked paint. I need some kind of tool.
Tak jo. Já bych to chtělo nějak odloupnout.
A fragment of an inscription. I need to uncover the rest.
Jo, je tam nějaký nápis.
A fragment of an inscription. I need to uncover the rest.
Jasně, ale jak? Dobrá, takže možná bychom to mohli nějak namočit a odškrábat. Ale zase, abychom to moc nezničili. Chtělo by to si na to připravit užiteční věcičky, to je jasný. Plouch, acetát. No.
The brush is dipped in polyvinyl acetate. It can be used for priming or protecting.
Takže, potřebujeme nejprve zakrýt ten nápis, abychom ho nepoškodili taky.
The uncovered inscription is protected. Now I need a strong chemical agent to dissolve the paint.
Teď to necháme sežrát něčím opravdu hodně agresivně.
This won't work.
No ne, přímo takhle to lejt asi nebudeme.
A bowl with lye. I'd better not put my hands inside.
To je mi polívčička.
Lye can burn holes in my skin. I'm not going to work with my bare hands.
No, od toho máme ty rukavice.
Now that my hands are protected, I can dip this brush even in lye.
To je dobrý. Rukavice držící kartáč. No.
With this brush, I can now spread the lye on some surface.
Jdeme na to, ale nebude to vypadat pěkně.
I dissolve the top layer of the paint.
teda lidi, tohle vidět v reálu, na nějakým opravdu hodně, hodně starým vzácným kusu dřeva, tak asi nebudu moc jako odvázaný z toho, ale je to v pořádku, teďka to potřebujeme nějak opláchnout.
Now it's time to reveal the protected part of the broadside.
Jo, Mary Celeste, no jasně. Ale ne, počkrábat.
Mary Celeste, awesome. Must be the remainder of the lifeboat from the derelict ship.
To je přímo prkno s nápisem ty lodi.
A fragment of the broadside inscribed Mary Celeste.
No, to jsi nečekal, co dětku, i když on to asi čekal.
So what do you think about it?
Excellent. It's Mary Celeste again.
Is everything connected with this ship?
It is quite possible.
Where did you get this broadside?
I bought it from an antiquary in Cairo. It must be a piece of the missing lifeboat.
So there are more?
Yes, I hope to buy all of them.
Why did you start this search?
Because of a premonition of a great mystery, a fundamental question.
And the answer?
If there is one, it is also going to be fundamental.
So, what is the question?
You are asking too much of me. I do not want to make a fool of myself. I only have a few clues so far.
And what can you tell me about Ponce de Leon's chest?
It was kept in Venice, first at the Scuola, then possibly here.
So we haven't come here by accident.
There are no accidents. What we consider an accident is just an event whose cause is unknown to us.
What happened to the chest when it disappeared from here?
What do you think?
Briggs got hold of it.
Bingo. You have become quite intriguing.
Three objects which disappeared along with the Mary Celeste crew have been found. The chronometer, the chest, and the lifeboat. What does it mean?
That they did not die. At least, not all of them. Somebody, maybe even the captain himself, came back.
It would have been strange if he'd been living and hiding the whole time after his return.
He certainly did not return with his wife and daughter. Those three would have been easily recognized.
His son and his mother stayed in Marion. I can't believe neither the captain nor his wife wanted to see them.
What if Mr. and Mrs. Briggs discovered something incredibly valuable and didn't want to reveal it?
It was a decent family. Everybody, including you, says Briggs was a very responsible man.
That is correct. Maybe he made a significant discovery but went into hiding because he was persecuted, hunted down.
By whom?
By someone from his entourage. A crew member, for instance.
What was at stake? What was the motivation behind all those events?
The journey of Mary Celeste had a secret goal, and it definitely was not about shipping alcohol across the ocean.
No, ale co to teda bylo?
What do you expect to find in the chest?
Have you examined it carefully?
Very.
And?
Please keep this for yourself for the time being. I haven't had time for proper research.
What have you found? Tell me.
Under the false bottom, I found a manuscript, possibly Ponce de Leon's notes, prepared as an account for the Casa de Contratación.
I knew it! I knew something was inside. Tell me more, please. What do his notes say?
He's describing his journey from 1513, during which he discovered Florida.
Is there anything new in that account of his? Something not present in other sources?
Yes. He mentions the Bimini Island where the Fountain of Youth was supposed to be located.
Did he reach it?
That's how I understood it.
I need to have that manuscript. No, I need to have the whole chest. God knows what else could be found inside.
Oh, I'm afraid that's impossible.
No, ale my jsme tam ještě něco našli. A to je ta mapa.
The chest is the property of the museum.
You will get it for me.
I can't act as your agent in front of them. They've given me a job and I need to bring it to a conclusion on the terms we agreed on.
No, you are working only for me now.
Come again? Have I suddenly become your property?
You are my expert. You cannot be doing two things at the same time.
Then I'm going back to France.
Please, you do not know what you would miss.
And I don't know what I'd miss if I stayed. Why do you insist on getting that chest?
I only want to examine it. I know the list of its contents, yet I am not so sure that it is everything.
There was a manuscript, a pistol, and a spout. The remains of a jug. I've got its copy.
True, the jug is on the list.
Do you know where the jug is at the moment?
I know one man in Cairo who might be in possession of it.
Who is he?
Ah, you see, you should not renounce the cause.
I shouldn't renounce my principles if I'm to work in this profession anymore.
You have discovered a lot. I esteem that. But you will not get any further without me.
Today, I found the place in the Scuola where the chest was stored for years.
You have? And what was inside?
A few strange seeds.
And where is this cache?
On the right-hand side of the entrance, under an absurd inscription on 12 tiles.
Yes, I remember that.
The tiles can be moved. I managed to arrange them into quite an elegant Latin maxim.
Well, well. And what is it, if I may ask?
Freely you have received, freely give.
How enlightening.
I'm curious about the relief on the floor.
Me too. It seems to be unfinished, as if it needed to be adjusted somehow.
Do you expect to find a cache here as well?
It is likely that the seeds from the Scuola di Santa Croce cache were brought and hidden here. They may still be in this place. You did not find them in the chest, did you?
No, I didn't.
Since you are able to deal with hiding places so well, maybe you could try your hand here.
Well, I'm not in a rush or anything. I need to have a closer look at this ornament. I've noticed, for example, that the circle in the middle is defective.
Yes, and some stone pieces are lying in the corner. A sloppy work, I must say.
Tady je to samý tajný ukryt. No tak jo, podíváme se na to.
I'm confused. Everything we've been discussing is just speculation. We have no irrefutable proof.
Scientists and discoverers can be divided into two categories. The first group build arduously, only on solid foundations. The second group consists of adventurers, eager to check even the most ridiculous theories once they feel there might be some truth in them. You do not belong to the former, do you?
I don't really know what to think. Are you trying to offend me?
Not at all. For me, it is an advantage. That is why I wanted to see you.
I hope I've lived up to your expectations.
Listen to me. I am impressed by your abilities and knowledge. You show the talents of a true discoverer. I am hiring you to be my expert.
Your expert? Expert in what?
In Marie Celeste. You will solve the mystery of the crew member's disappearance unarguably, once and for all.
I'm flattered. It's an incredibly ambitious endeavor.
I will cover all your expenses. And as for the remuneration, what would satisfy you?
Let me think. Okay, let's start from the simplest matter. Exclusive rights to the book on the subject.
Naturally.
Access to all the valuable and antique objects we come across during this enterprise, as well as exclusive rights to analyzing them.
It sounds reasonable, I agree.
And now the crucial part. I'll own a tenth of those relics and have the right of first refusal when it comes to the rest.
My investment rights are strictly limited, taking into account your potential achievements.
I think my offer is fair. I won't have any reward if I don't achieve anything. I risk returning empty-handed.
There is something up your sleeve. You will always be able to write a book about it.
I get the feeling that there's something up your sleeve, too. It's not only about Marie Celeste.
All right, I agree. But I also want to make one condition. Let us leave the chest out of it. It will belong to me.
On to s tou truhlou prostě pořád a pořád zkouší.
I'm going back to work.
I hope to talk to you soon.
No tak dobře, když to zmákne, budeme mít další knížku a to znamená další přednášku, na kterou zase nikdo nepřijde. No, fajn. Cože to říkal o těch úlomcích? Tady jsou nějaký, to je jasný, ale to prozkoumat nejde. A počká, tady něco je.
Pieces of stone plates, broken pottery, all in all, a small dump.
Jeden úlomek, druhý, čtvrtý. Nic jich tady asi není.
A chipped off piece of the floor. A chipped off piece of the floor.
Ty úlomky mají různý tvary.
A chipped off piece of the floor. A chipped off piece of the floor.
Naprosto starý popisek. Ale pokud jsem si všiml dobře, tak na tom reliéfu chybí jenom jedna část. Takže bude chtít tam uložit ten správnej. Trojúhelníkový úlomek, to by mohlo být tenhle. Jo.
Now the relief is complete, but the pattern on the floor doesn't make a hole.
To bychom měli a teďka ještě nějak otočit ty kruhy, aby to dalo dohromady ten tvar toho stromu. Ale koukám, že když otáčím jedním, tak to pohybuje i s dalšíma. A sakra, sakra. Takhle by to mělo být uprostřed správně, tenhle ten s kmenem, jenomže ty vnější dva jsou špatně. Sakra, co to bylo? Ale nějak to zaklaplo. Teďka otáčím tři kruhy.
Notice that now the second and the fourth rings are moving together.
All set. The pattern on the rings shows a lush tree.
Ty dlaždice jakoby pověly nějak nahoru.
The tile sticks out a bit now. It's a stash for the seeds. They must have been considered valuable.
Další semínka, no výborně.
These seeds are different from the ones I found at the Skola.
Ale vypadá to, že si je nevereme sebou. Škoda, už jsem myslel, že si vypěstujeme vlastní zahrádku.
These seeds are different from the ones I found at the Skola.
Taky nějaký jiný.
These seeds are different from the ones I found at the Skola.
Takže to jsou pochopitelně až ty poslední, je to vůbec možný?
These seeds are like the ones found at the Skola. They were brought by the conquistadors in his chest.
No? To teď? To ti šlo, dětku, o semínka.
The ornament is legible now.
I must admit you have performed marvelously again.
Do you know what tree this is?
I have seen it somewhere, but I cannot remember where.
Is it related to Mary Celeste in any way?
I feel that it is.
Feelings are not enough when it comes to such an enterprise. Do you know that I've seen that emblem on a coin as well?
On a coin?
On two coins, actually. I found one of them near the place where Marcel, the restorer from the museum, died.
The friend of yours? The one I wrote to is dead?
Unfortunately, yes. And I found the second coin today at the site of your man's death.
Two coins, two deaths.
And one murderer, right?
He is following you. What was that? Did you hear that?
No, I didn't.
Never mind.
There are some seeds in the floor stash.
I knew it!
They're similar to the ones from the Scuola. Have a look.
I feel they can give me the answer, but I do not know the question.
I wonder if this is the tree that grows on the islands from the map.
What islands? What map?
No, my jsme mu o té mapě ještě neřekli.
I haven't mentioned it yet, but I've found a map in the manuscript.
You have saved the best for last. I need that map. What is on it?
A few islands, but their names are missing.
You see, I need to buy that chest after all.
It's not necessary. I've made a copy of the map. I brought it with me.
May I see it? I am sure we can come to an agreement.
Yes.
Splendid. What was that?
I haven't noticed anything.
Hush!
Ten pán je nějak paranoidní, ne? Nechtělo by to vylečit?
What's going on?
Someone was following you.
Nobody was following me.
It does not matter anymore. You should go back.
What's next? Where will we meet?
I am compromised in Venice. Only Cairo is left.
Cairo is a huge city?
I mean that collector. He often comes to the old town. He specializes in artifacts connected with Atlantis. Did you see that shadow?
Where?
Go now, quickly.
What about the collector?
Run! It must be the killer!
This gondolier for Omega.
It doesn't matter. I'll get him a bit later.
It does. If someone's worthless life means anything to you.
You've had your heart transplanted or what?
Knock it off. We'll get him. This girl will lead us to him.
Do you think they're connected in any way? She's like a moth flying towards the light.
This is what we should hope for.